So today we're going to talk about how to sort aluminum with X-ray, and then we're going to talk about how to libs after that, and we're going to talk about the pros and cons of libs and X-ray. So first of all, in our view here at SciAps, well, we spend a lot of time making X-ray work better on aluminum. The historically the Achilles heel for X-ray has been aluminum alloys, and that's because testing magnesium and silicon has been really slow. So we've done a lot of hard work to make X-ray work as fast on aluminum and as well on aluminum as it does on stainless and high temps. So there's three ways to do it. All right, so let's start with the first way. If you just see, you know, a dozen different aluminum grades and you don't really want to sort them out really precisely into grades, then there's a really great quick way to do it. All right, and that is you set this thing up in a single beam test and show you how good this can be. 1 or 2 seconds, it tells you the alloy, 5083 type. Let's go to this one, 5052 type. All right, so that's 5052. Let's go to this one, like a 3003. So how does it know? Why does it say 3003 type? It's because it sees the high manganese up around 1%. And in the simple way to do it, the gun is trained to say, if I see about 1% manganese, it's most likely a 3003. What's another good one? Let's do this one. Shoot this one, 6062. Why does it say that? Because it says, oh, I've seen lead and bismuth, and that's most likely a 6262. So that's how this thing works. Let's take one more. Where's my 2024, calling any 2024? There it is, shoot this one. So 2024, because it sees high copper. Same with the 7000s. I don't have one handy, but 7000, it sees high copper, high zinc. It knows it's a 7000. So that's great for if you only encounter a few of the most common aluminum alloys. But notice, for example, it says 2024 type. Well, here's where you get into danger using this very quick and simple method. Is what happens if you encounter a wider variety of aluminum alloys? So for example, here's a 3003 we talked about earlier. All right, 3003 type because the manganese. But what if you actually encounter a 3005? And so it still says 3003. Why? Because the only difference between an 03 and an 05 is magnesium. So unless you measure magnesium, you can't tell these apart. And then here's my favorite mix-up that I see when people are doing things too fast, is the 6063 1100. Hey, NASCAR. All right. Good to see you. Is there CJ McLaughlin, our Xfinity driver and trucks this year?
Yeah.
All right.
Who's going on?
Yep, it is. So hey, we're just talking about aluminum sorting with X-ray.
Fantastic. Yep. This is the way to go then.
Yep, that's right. So stick around. We got to talk about the racing season, right? Yeah, but until then, can we just work through this?
Yeah, you can handle the important stuff. I'll just...
All right. Yeah. Leave the thinking to. So back to 6063. So this is my favorite mix-up, right? Is that you got to be careful doing this quick and dirty way on a 6063, because it calls it a 6063 type, but if you look at the screen, there's no magnesium, and you need to see about 0.6% or so, between 0.4 and 0.8, roughly, magnesium to really know it's a 63. So I see 1100 and 6063. I see them mixed up all the time because people try to do them really fast, and it's easy to mix them up. If you don't measure that magnesium, you really shouldn't be calling it 6063. All right, but that's the deal. If you just have a small universe and you don't deal with a lot of the more, you know, esoteric aluminum grades, this quick sorting method is probably going to be just fine for a lot of, especially a lot of smaller recyclers. Now, if you do encounter a wider variety of grades, then you want to use what's called the faster but and also more precise way of doing it. And for that, we have this you go into what we call the auto beam, which when it's doing aluminum, it automatically uses two beams. So those of you that know X-ray know what that means. It shoots for a few seconds with one setting, then it shoots for a few seconds at another setting to measure magnesium and silicon. And that's how that works. So historically, people don't want to do that with X-ray, because some of these old guns, it takes them 30 seconds or 60 seconds or longer to measure 0.5% or 1% magnesium. And nobody's going to want to stand there and shoot a piece of material for a minute in order to sort it. So historically, people have avoided X-ray for that reason. It's just too slow on that magnesium and silicon measurement. But we put a lot of time and effort into making that measurement fast as stainless and high temps, nickels, things like that. So now you can do it fast. You can actually think about sorting these metals, a wider variety of aluminums, in maybe 5 or 6 seconds instead of 30 or 60. So let me show you. So for example, let's go back to my favorite example, the 6063. Now when I shoot that, again, it says 6063 type, but when it flips over to that second beam, now look what's happened. In a few more seconds, you're measuring that 0.6% magnesium. Now you know for sure it's 6063. If I shoot the at 1100, same thing. Gets it right, but when it flips over, now you don't measure any magnesium, so it confirms it's indeed 1100. So the power of that is it takes a little longer. Now it's taking maybe 4 or 5 seconds to do that, but that's better than 30 seconds or a minute like the older X-ray guns. And that's something we really invented, we're really proud of. And we sell a lot of analyzers now, a lot of X-ray guns for aluminum testing because it's so much faster. Another great example, remember that 3005 that we called 3003. Same story, when it flips over to that second beam, give it a few more seconds, there's your low magnesium, so it knows it's a 3005. Remember when we shot it originally, without doing that, it'll call it a 3003. And then another great example is that 2024. So when it makes the magnesium measurement, it really nails it as 2024. Unlike 2014, for example, if you shoot this guy, when it flips over, it doesn't see any magnesium, so it knows it's 2014, not 2024. So that's how that works. That second beam, a few more seconds, but if you need to really sort out a wide variety of aluminum alloys and you want to do it quickly, that's the way to do it. All right. So that's all in this X-505 model we have on the market. Now, if you really want to do it fast on those aluminums, you can step up a little bit in price, but step up to the X-550 model. This is our premium X-ray model. And what this comes with something we call the aluminum app. So I'm just going to take a second, and I'm going to switch so we can see the display on the computer. First, we talked about doing aluminum common grades quickly, which works for some of the smaller facilities. Then with the 505, we showed how you can do a lot of these grades that have small differences in mag or silicon, how you can do those pretty quickly too. If you do a lot of aluminum and you want to sort your aluminum in one or 2 seconds as opposed to 3 or 4, then you can step up a little bit in price to our premium model, the X-550. And that model comes with our patented aluminum app. And what that does is that takes advantage of the fact that if you measure magnesium and silicon, you can identify most aluminum alloys very quickly. So we've designed the unit to be able to do that. So let's take a few shots. First of all, we'll do the easy stuff. All right, 1100. So I see about 1 second, 1100. All right, 6063, where is it? All right, about 1 second, 6063, perfect match. What else can we go to? There's all kinds of good stuff here. Here's our 3003. 1 second, 3003. Here's that tricky 3005 that took a little longer. Not with the X-550, just in a couple of seconds, 3005. So it's just really fast on all your aluminum grades. Here's a 3105. We don't see that a lot, but there you go. And it still does everything, but it just does everything really fast. 5052 is like 1 second. There's your almost 2.5% magnesium. So to summarize, if you just want blistering speed and the best possible accuracy on the widest range of aluminum alloys, you want the 550, the premium model alloy sorter. And like I said, we've got that patented aluminum map. It is just, there's nothing else like it on the market. You know, if you're not doing tons and tons of aluminum a day, the 505 will be a great choice. It's a couple thousand dollars less expensive. You can do your easy grades in 1 or 2 seconds, and you can do your harder grades in about 4 or 5 seconds. So unless you need that extra speed, this is a great analyzer to do that. Both work great in high temps, stainless, red metals, turnings, you know, specialty alloys, tungsten carbides, everything. You can shoot everything with these. But we've really invested a lot in making aluminum as good on X-ray as stainless and high temps. There you go.